Hello guys, this is Revan from Digi Integrity. Today we are going to see some interesting tech news in episode 2 Note 8. Apple has announced a new event for October 18th. The Apple event will be hosted a day ahead of the Google Pixel 6 launch event. This is among the new instances when Apple will host an event on a Monday. The event titled Unleashed will be hosted virtually at 10:30 PM IST, that is around 10 AM PT time. Apple is expected to announce the new MacBook Pro models at the Unleashed Apple event. The new MacBook Pros are expected to feature the much rumored M1X chip. Apple is also expected to unveil a new AirPods at the event on October 18th. Sony is not known for releasing phones on a spear, with the launches like the Xperia 10 III Lite, Xperia 1 III, Xperia 5 III and Xperia 10 III. It was thought that the company is done and dusted with their offering for 2021. However, the Japanese company has now surprised us with all this latest announcement. Sony took to Twitter today to declare a new Xperia product announcement to be held on October 26. No other information was provided apart from this. However, considering the fact that Xperia is a brand name of smartphones and the tablets from Sony, it is safe to assume that the product to be launched will be indeed be a tablet or a phone. Battleground Mobile India has some competition. At this time, it is from a homegrown player which actually launched way back in 2019, Maskgun, which is an Indian-based first-person shooter game, has managed to cross over 50 million users. This is a rare achievement for a game that has been created in India, especially since it is not seen a kind of hype that others like 4G has seen in the past. The title has been developed by India Super Gaming, which is based in Pune. To celebrate this achievement, Maskgun is set to offer 50 hours of double XP and gold in game this weekend for the first time ever. Moto E40 has launched in India with a price tag of ₹9,499. Key Moto E40 specifications include a 6.5-inch HD+ display, Unisoc T700 chipset and a decent 5000mAh battery, Android 11 OS and a 48-megapixel camera. Moto E40 will be available starting from October 17th. Xiaomi has recently teased the launch of new TV series from its Redmi sub-brand. While the company has been promoting its new Mi TV Master series, it has now showcased that the Redmi Smart TV X 2022. Google has once again purged several stalkerware ads from its Play Store, prompting apps that violated its policies. Stalkerware applications are generally discussed under a fake app name with suspicious access to messages, call logs, location and other personal activity. Once downloaded, these applications has been repurposed by people to spy on the smartphones of their spouses. Instagram is working on new in-app features. It will notify users on outages and their account status. It will test the feature in the US before making it available to a wider audience. Realme GT Neo 2T is set to launch on October 19th in China. Ahead of the launch, Realme has showcased the white color variant of this device. The Realme GT Neo 2T will feature a 64-megapixel main camera. Realme Narzo 50 and Narzo 50 Pro India launch is expected to happen later this month or in early November. This handset will join the existing Narzo 50A and Narzo 50i series. Realme Narzo 50 and 50 Pro specifications are yet to be revealed. The Xiaomi Vice President and Redmi General Manager had just teased the arrival of a new smartphone series. The official took to Weibo, the Chinese microblogging platform, to hint at a launch of the Note 11 series. Google is working on a new Pixel 6 lineup that will be a new Pixel Stand 2. Some renders of the wireless charger were shared online last week, but now a new image comes to confirm the design and a little bit more information about it. The bulkier design is to be expected as it now incorporates a cooling fan to enable the faster charging. There are also two charging coils, one for the phone and other for the compatible wearables. The fast charging goes up to 23 watt for the selected Pixel models and 15 watt for QI certified wearables, and up to 3 watts for the Pixel Buds. IQ 9 Pro has appeared on the IMEI database, suggesting that the India launch could be soon. This flagship bears the model number I2022. IQ 9 Pro IMEI database doesn't reveal its hardware specifications. WhatsApp is spotted working on a new section to let users manage their chat backup size and exclude specific content such as document and photos from their cloud backup. According to the report, the change could initially be limited to Android devices and may work with the backups being stored on a Google Drive. And WhatsApp is also separately seems working on a feature called as Community that could help provide a better group conversation experience. Both new backup size management and the community features are yet to be introduced for beta testing. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.